What's up, JR?
What up, man? That's a hot intro, actually.
You like that?
Yeah, that was pretty
cool. Made it up in 20 seconds.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was nice.
So, I was really digging what we just did with the first part of our interview.
Okay, cool, yeah.
Me and you talking back and forth.
Appreciate it.
Two friends hanging out.
Yeah.
So, I thought we could also pretend we have a radio show.
Okay,
just
yeah.
Just kind of talk back and forth.
Yeah.
But kind of keep it as if we're on the bone.
Okay, if that's what you really want to do, yeah, I'm down for it.
Because you never know what can happen.
Okay.
Because you don't want to go doing an Opie and Anthony act or Sirius XM where every other word's a swear word.
Yeah.
You would want to do a show where people are like, okay, I could see them doing that Saturdays or Sundays, 2 to 3 a.m.
Uh-huh. All right. You know yeah. I mean, I'm always working Saturdays and Sundays. But I get what you're saying, yeah.
Tuesday overnight, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got you, yeah.
You know what I'm saying or heard what I said?
Yeah. I won't stay up that late, though. But I got you, man. I got you, man.
So I saw this in the news, dude. This is crazy.
Okay.
And it makes you realize that cops do break the law at times. Not just like, you know, swerving through lanes and not using turn signals. This is the most Florida thing to come out of the news this year.
Okay. Yeah, I think Florida right now so far is going strong with the crazy stories coming out. Yeah. I think they're in the Hall of Fame right now this year.
Now, if you were a cop, before I get into this.
Uh-huh. I can't see myself as a cop, but I get you.
This picture of J.R. Baltazar, Officer Baltazar.
I'd be like the most corrupt, crooked cop, you know? I swear. I'd be pulling over drug dealers and taking their drugs and using it for myself.
So here's what I think you would do. This, what I'm about to read to you, yells JR then.
Oh, okay.
If you would be a crooked cop.
Yeah.
Married Florida sheriff, which would be you.
Okay, yeah. I wouldn't be married. I'd be whatever.
Yeah.
I get you.
You would be caught having sex in the cop car after working a 12th grade football game. So a senior game.
Nah, I like older women, so I wouldn't be caught having sex with a high school chick.
No, in the parking lot.
Oh, okay.
Of the high school. Would you be feeling kind of kinky? And you're like, hey, look, I got the badge.
Yeah.
I got the car.
Yeah.
Like, are you into having sex in cars or in public? Because for me, I just want to get it done in the bedroom where I feel safe and I won't get caught.
Yeah. You want to have sex somewhere where it's dark and nobody can see you naked. Yeah,
that's,
right?
that's a plus for the girls.
Yeah.
Every time.
Yeah. I don't mind having sex in public. I'm not going to do it like around a school or something like that. But sure as hell, if they want to have sex on a beach or something like that, I'm down for it.
Yeah, dude, it's crazy to think that a cop would think he's going to get away with that. But you know, that's the whole Big D attitude where they feel so cool because they're above the law that it's okay to do that. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I get it. You know, like a cop was like, you know what? I'm feeling a little risky. I want to do it in my uniform. You know, I got my gun on me. I got my badge on me. Why not? Let's do it.
Dude, that must be the biggest high, though. If you're like in the front seat and the girl's like going down on you and you're just like, I'm a cop, and this is going down in my patrol car. That must be the biggest turn-on.
Yeah. And you're like, let me whip out them handcuffs. Now you get in the back seat. Yeah, let me put these handcuffs on you. Now sit in the back. Let me take you to jail, girl. All right, yeah. Now this is still the sex act. All right, now we're taking you to jail, right? Let me fingerprint you real quick. I'm going to write out this report. You know what I'm saying? After I write out this report, hey, look, I'm going to bail you out, but you're going to go to jail and sit one night, man. This turned me on.
Man. It makes you really wonder how often cops break the law with this. Oh, they must just think this is the biggest power trip. Like, I bet if you're like a deputy or the head sheriff, I bet you just bang your wife right on your desk in your office.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to say that. No, I don't think so. This is my thing. Like, I feel like a lot, like, there's going to be some bad apples out there. I don't think all cops are doing, you know, what he's doing. I know there's going to be like a lot of cops out there that are actually doing their job.
You know, they kind of get turned on, though, by their power. Like, they would definitely have sex in the office. Like, look at me. It's on my desk. I'm just saying, I feel like because they're so uptight and they have to put on such a tough guy act, that I feel like they need to let loose.
Yeah. But I don't feel, like I said, I don't feel like all cops are like that, though. I want to say some are, but not all of them.
So then this is just, if you think most cops aren't doing it, then what I'm about to read you is just happening once in a while. Because I think it's happening more often.
Right.
A small town in Florida. Their cop, he was a married sheriff's deputy who allegedly received oral sex at the wheel of his car from a counselor of the same high school that was playing their game.
So she was over 18. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's all that matters. I don't see nothing wrong with that.
Indian River County Sheriff's Deputy James Cousins, who was forced to resign last month over claims of his sexual encounter with married Vero Beach teacher Rebecca Turner after a football game in September. A report obtained by TMZ reveals the affair came to light after rumors began to swirl after she got a ride home 90 minutes away in his cop car. Dude, he was just trying to get caught. He's driving around, whatever. Yeah. He's being seen, whatever. Dude, he was just begging to get caught. Like, he was not low-key about this affair at all.
I think in his head, he's in a cop car. Nobody's going to suspect him getting a BJ.
But if he's with the same chick and you're driving 90 minutes with her, people are going to start to wonder.
I mean, you're patrolling the area. How many times have you seen a cop out there just driving around the area, just kind of patrolling it? You don't really suspect much.
Oh, man, this is the part where they really need to think things out. Mm-hmm. It's always these teachers that get kinky, if it's with kids or people that they work with within the office.
That's why I like teachers.
Because you know they get down.
Oh, yeah.
Like this teacher.
Yeah.
There were nude photos being sent while she was at work on Snapchat to the officer.
Oh, really? Are they on the story? Let me see them real quick.
Well, there's a picture of her. She's hot, dude.
Yeah, she's all right.
Well, you wouldn't have sex with that? I'll tweet that out at Ryan Hoppe Radio. You wouldn't hook up with that.
No, I would. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'd be sober doing it. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I just can't believe a cop would think he can get away with that.
No, you know what?
It's a power trip.
I don't want to say it's a power trip, but I guess when you're in the mood and you're having fun and you're in a cop car, that's the last thing you suspect, that another cop is going to pull you over and is going to arrest you for you having fun.
I bet the girl gets really into it, too. I bet she's like, please handcuff me, officer. I bet.
Oh, yeah.
She puts a lot of effort into it.
Yeah, yeah. She really gets into it. Yeah. Yeah. She's like, yeah, fingerprint me, too.
You know what was weird? This is the most Florida thing you'll ever say. Like, the people that are going to be listening up north to this will be so offended by this.
Yeah.
But don't you wish there was a part of St. Pete Beach, maybe you pay 10 to 20 bucks to get in, and then you can have sex on the beach, and it's closed off?
Yeah.
You have like a wristband, because I refuse to hook up with a girl on a beach because I don't want to get caught by a cop because I'm not coordinated. I've talked about this on air. I would get caught in a second.
Yeah.
But don't you wish there's a part of like St. Pete Beach or like Indian Rocks where you pay the cover charge to get in?
Yeah.
And it's kind of like a sex club, but it's not really.
Yeah. I mean, you're going to have a lot of creepy ass people like just going in there just to watch. Yeah. But I mean, look, if you're smart enough, you know that. If you're going to have sex on the beach, you got to do it in 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not saying I have experience, but I'm just saying if you don't want to get caught, do it under 5 minutes. Just, one and done. Just go in there and get out.
It's just nerve wracking because there's times things are happening and then I go, we can't. And then every time I do that, when we're walking back to Jimmy B's beach bar, me and the girl, I swear I've been smart every time because then the cop drives by and I go, that's why I didn't.
You know, and that's the thing. I think people who are having sex on the beach and getting caught, they're just dumb. They're just not looking. They're just having sex and making a bunch of noise. But I guarantee you there's times where people are having sex out there on the beach or whatever. There's got to be a one lookout person. You know, when one person's on top, you got to be the lookout person. I think that's the rule.
Yeah, you definitely need to have a friend that will send you a text and be like, yo, 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 cops are coming. Pull up your pants. You got to have your one dude look out for you.
Yeah, you got to have one dude look out for you or whoever's on top looks out. That's does that make sense? Like, that's the easiest way to go about it.
Dude, you're from Chicago.
Yes.
How amazing is it that we live at the beach, essentially?
Yeah, it's paradise out here. It really is paradise.
It's crazy to think about.
Yeah, it is. But we have Lakeshore Drive, though. It's kind of a beach, right?
Yeah, I would agree.
I mean, it's like beach-ish.
Also negative 20 out 4 months of the year, so it's not really a beach.
Yeah, that's true. And the water's kind of nasty out there, too.
It's terrible.
Yeah, I wouldn't jump in there. It's like polluted right now, isn't it? Like maybe that's like on Lakeshore Drive.
I think it's polluted all the time.
Yeah.
Now, I want to ask you, do you think the sunshine in Florida and the hot weather, do you think it makes people do dumb things?
Yeah, I think when the hotter it gets, the dumber you get, yeah.
Dude, I bet you talked about this on the Crazy AIDS back in September. I just found out about it because my mom didn't want to tell me. Mm-hmm. So
why didn't she want to tell you?
Okay, let me explain.
Yeah.
So I grew up Roman Catholic.
Yeah.
I don't really believe in God. Pretty much atheist. I just don't want to admit I'm atheist, but I don't believe in God.
Yeah.
And I grew up Roman Catholic for 18 years. Went to church every Sunday, got confirmed, mm-hmm. got my first communion,
got baptized, all, yeah.
everything.
Yeah.
My confirmation, my sponsor was the priest at my church, mm-hmm. who is like this 31-year-old dude from Cuba, mm-hmm. really good looking. He kind of had the vibe of you. It'd be like if you were a priest.
Okay, yeah, yeah. That wouldn't happen. I would.
And then 10 years later,
yeah.
you're in Miami.
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead.
And you get caught going down on another man in a parking lot.
Oh, yeah. I remember the story. Yeah, yeah.
That was my priest. That was my priest that confirmed me.
No, really?
I swear to God.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So I remember what happened was that they were parked on the side of the road when they were doing this, right? That was the story, right?
It was inside a parked car in Miami Beach.
Yeah, and it was just like right there on the side of the road, and everybody could just walk by and see him.
Dude.
I think that was the story, right?
Yeah, and this was on a busy road, a popular hotspot for tourists and nightlife.
Yeah.
You just got to picture it from my view. I just found out about this.
Yeah, picture it from your view. Yeah, you're walking down the road, and you see two guys blowing each other.
And imagine being me, hearing 3 months later that 10 years ago, the dude that confirmed me went down on another man and got caught. Like, just think about the idea that when you're going to church every week when you're a kid, that in 10 years, you're going to be doing a podcast talking about him giving guy some sweet loving.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, all right, so for me, right, my high school chemistry teacher, his Dang Van Den, I don't care, I'm going to say it anyway. He was actually caught sleeping with one of his students. And I never thought that was going to happen, but years later, after everything happened, he was caught.
Did you ever have a crush on a teacher?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It would be the teachers that were in their mid to late 20s or maybe up to 33. That was like the range of
high. Yeah, my 7th grade teacher, Miss Sherry. Oh, man, she was a nice dark chocolate that I've always wanted to taste.
So I'm a weird guy now, but I was weird in 9th to 12th grade, and I used to have a crush on this teacher named Miss Gilman.
Yeah.
So what I would do is, I wasn't very good at math anyway, so it seemed kind of real when I would say, can you help me with math after class?
Yeah.
But I swear to God, dude, I would have her class as the last period of the day. So it'd be 2:50.
Mm-hmm.
And I literally would not leave my chair, and then she would work on the math homework with me.
Yeah.
And the whole time I was rock hard, just so excited. Like, oh, I'm just hoping that the porn comes to life. Never did.
Yeah. It never happens like that. It never does, man.
But now it's happening all the time. You look at the news, you're seeing it's legit happening, and you're like, why couldn't that have been me?
Yeah. You know what? And I'm wondering, like, what, I know this is wrong to think about it. I'm like, but who are these teachers? Like, what kind of kids are these? Like, how much swagger do they have to have for them to sleep with these teachers?
And how damaged are the females? How emotionally damaged are you for having sex with a 15-year-old to a 17-year-old is a turn on.
And I think that goes back to my argument. Like, a lot of these teachers are a little older, so the guys that are their age or around their age, they're not doing them justice sexually. So they have to kind of go for that younger guy in order for them to be satisfied. Does that make sense? You know, to...
I think it's almost like maybe the girls, because a lot of these teachers, they're really hot, but they seem like the type of girls that are coming into their own. Like, I bet they were dorky girls that ran track back in 9th to 12th grade.
Yeah. So all the chicks that ran track in my high school were hot.
So what I'm saying is the girls that got the most attention, hear me out, were the cheerleaders, were the hot pieces of asses that everybody would say that. They were like, I want to hook up with this girl.
Yeah.
I want to hook up with this girl. But think about this. I wonder if the teachers that are now hooking up with the kids, I wonder if they were kind of overlooked, like they were the second tier hot girls.
Yeah.
So when these 17-year-old boys who are the cool kids of their class have a crush on them, I wonder if it brings them back to when they wanted to be the girls that got laid when they were in 10th to 11th grade. So then they kind of have this turn on where they feel like they're 17 or 18 again. I wonder if it's this like thing where they weren't cool growing up. So they kind of are reliving their fantasy that they never were able to relive. Because you know, there were those girls that were in our graduation class for yours and mine that you look at them now and you go, you were cute 10 years ago, but you are a dime piece now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. A lot of them, they kind of outgrow that ugly duckling phase. Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
These teachers were the cute ducklings. Kind of hot, but weren't ready. And then it's the girls, bro, that were hot in 9th to 12th grade that are washed up now.
Yeah, that's true. Or, you know, a lot of these teachers are looking at these young boys that are 17 going on to 18 years old. You know, a lot of these 17-year-old guys are really fit, skinny, tall. I mean, I could see why a woman might want to, you know, might like that. Does that make sense?
Do you think, pornography speeds up the process because it makes people think about this scenario more? Because if you go on Pornhub.com or Xvideos,
it's
teachers and MILFs.
Teachers and MILFs. Yeah, that's where I usually go.
I'm into the MILF thing because it seems more believable, but I'm 10 years removed from ninth grade.
Yeah.
So the whole thing of hooking up with a teacher just seems like old news. Like, I might as well watch old Obama speeches because that was my era.
No, I gotcha. I mean, yeah, it's a little played out right now, but I think, like I said, man, a lot of these teachers right now, they're just kind of looking for somebody who's who has a lot of stamina. And that's what I think, you know, is going on right now. That's where that's the reason why they're going for these young guys, because they have a lot more stamina than these 30 to 40 year olds.
You know what's funny, though? You know what's funny, bro?
What's that?
Is the fact that when it's a dude that's 27 years old banging a girl that's 17, we think there should be the death penalty for him. But when it's a 27-year-old teacher banging a 17-year-old boy, there seems to be this thing where everyone's like, yeah, I wish that was me growing up.
In a weird way, man, I'm cool with double standards. And I hate saying it like that, but I'm cool with, like, not double standards in terms of race, but double standards. But double standards in terms of male and female. Like it's cool for a woman to masturbate in public, but it's not cool for a guy to masturbate in public. I'm okay with that. Does that make sense?
Remember that girl in the library 4 years ago? I think her name is Kendra something.
Mm-hmm.
She was like masturbating herself in the library.
Yeah, she was masturbating in the library.
Could you imagine if I did that?
Yeah, if you did that, that would be so creepy. But if she did that, I'd be like, all right, that's cool. And that's the thing. Like, I'm okay with that double standard. Like, I'm all right with it. But, all right. And I know this is not a popular take on this, but I know when I was 17, I was trying to do everything in my power to lose my virginity. I was so horny. I was just, I didn't know what to do with myself.
Yeah.
So a lot of these 17-year-old males, yeah, I get it. Like, they're being preyed upon by these older women. On top of that, they're just trying to lose their virginity and have sex.
You know what the weirdest thing was? Would you just ever get randomly turned on in class?
Me?
Yeah, like, you're 17 years old and you're in science class.
I get randomly turned on now. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, of course. You know, like when you're going through puberty, that's what's happening.
It's not that my sex drive has gone down a lot. But I think my sex drive 3 years ago, when I wasn't, and I'm not saying I get laid a lot, but when I was not getting laid at all, just maybe here and there, I feel like my sex drive was through the roof. But I feel like now that I'm 25, I'm like, eh, like, sex is cool, but I feel like I don't chase it as much.
You don't chase it as much?
Like,
All right. So there's a difference, right? So right now your sex drive is, you know, it's, you still like it's eh, right?
I mean, when I'm really into it, I can go.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is,
how about this? When you're training for your boxing matches and stuff like that, for your fights, did you notice that your sex drive went up a little bit?
Oh yeah,
exactly. And I think like that, and I think that's a main component. You know, when you're keeping yourself healthy and fit and stuff like that, and you're keeping that testosterone up, you can still keep that sex drive up.
Yeah, I felt kind of bad. My coach sent me a text the other day. He was my boxing coach, Eric Marshall. He's like, "You're getting fat." And I saw a picture of me at a party last night that I was tagged in.
Yeah.
And I can tell I've gained like 7 to 8 pounds. You can see it in the face. And I was like, I'm going to the gym tomorrow. I kind of was like,
ugh. You weren't happy with yourself.
Like, I'm not unhappy with myself, but I was just kind of like, you were just in good shape back in November. Like, what are you doing?
I think you could put yourself back into shape. I think for me, if I really want to get back into shape, really, really get back into shape, it'll just take me a month.
Yeah.
I'm at that point with my body where it's like, I know what to eat, what to cut out, what to, you know, what to do. And I think you're at that point with your body too. If you really want to do it, you could do it within a month.
It's when you don't drink. When you cut out beer altogether, beer is just empty calories and it makes you want to have junk food.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you get like that. After a few beers, I want any junk food, any bad food for me.
Yeah, well, my thing is, like, I try not to eat fast food in general or eat fried food. I try to cut down on my sugar intake, and that helps. So if you try to maintain that kind of, like, that, you know, those kind of restrictions, that always will benefit.
Do you do meal prep?
Nah, not really.
I want to start doing it more.
Yeah. Not as much as I used to, but yeah. I mean, I used to, but not anymore.
I'm the guy where I'll watch, like, Jersey Shore, and I'm like, oh, I want to do the keto diet. So then I do it for like an hour, and then I get a coffee with sugar, and then the app says I've had enough sugar for the week. And I'm like, damn it. Like, I really need to focus if I want to lose weight.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I go through these phases, bro. I'll go through a phase where I lose a bunch of weight and then I gain some back. And I really just got to just keep going.
Yeah. You got it, man. Just keep going, man. You'll be fine.
I feel you. How often do you work out usually?
Well, it varies. So I try to stay active at least 3 days a week. So whether it be me doing a long distance run, being 6 miles to almost a half a marathon, to me going to the gym, I always try to maintain some sort of active routine.
So let's say you walk into the gym and you're really not in the mood to work out.
Yeah.
But you drink your pre-workout.
Yeah.
And you walk into the gym and it's playing this song and it's pumping you up. What's the first machine you work on when you're working out?
I'll try to find the hottest chick in the gym. And if she's doing like the elliptical or something like that, I'll do it next to her. That'll kind of pump me up, right? Because if you see like another hot female, it makes you want to like, you know what? Like you're good enough for me. You know what I'm saying? And it makes you want to be pumped up for her.
See, the gym is the one time where I don't think about girls because I'm just trying to think about the girls that I can get outside the gym. Like, I want it to be more organic. Yeah. Like, if I'm hitting on a girl at the gym, I feel like I'm not doing enough of what I could be doing at the gym.
I'm not going to hit on her. I don't pay any attention to them, but I just kind of like look at them. I'm like, yeah, you know what? I'm better than you.
And what's the first machine you lift on as you're at the gym?
It depends. If I'm doing legs, if I'm doing arms, if I'm doing chest, it really just depends on how I'm feeling that day.
I have a bad back, so I feel like I end up hurting myself, so now I just swim.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. Swim is really a really good cardiovascular exercise.
What makes me sad, though, is they don't play the hard rock that they play in the main room, in the swimming room.
Yeah.
So I feel like if I was able to hear this while swimming, it would just pump me up. Like, imagine you don't feel like doing any more laps, but you hear Enter the Sandman, it's pumping you up.
Yeah, let's go. Let's do this. Yeah, exactly.
But here's what I hear when I'm swimming.
You hear nothing.
But when you're lifting outside. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do the squats. But swimming.
Yeah. It's not the same. Yeah. I don't hear Metallica. I usually if I'm listening to music, I listen to a little bit of EDM, some hip hop. I actually listen to Slipknot. I used to listen to a lot of Slipknot.
What's an EDM song you listen to when you're at the gym? Like, what's like the genre you listen to?
Let me see. I would probably do Club Action and Propaganda. Club Action versus Propaganda.
And what is it so? And what is it about the song that you like?
It's just fast paced. It just gets you going, and it's a heavy beat. So, yeah, it's really heavy, and it's really nice.
You seem like the guy. I feel like you listen to bunch of different genres. I feel like you're not just one genre.
Yeah, I listen to everything, man. I even listen to country sometimes. Not all the time, though.
That's the one I cannot get into at all.
Not all country, though. Yeah, that first one. There you go.
And this is JR's pump up song to get him in the mood to lift.
Yeah,
on the treadmill.
Yeah, there it is.
Have you seen them live?
Who?
This band.
Oh, no, it's not a band. It's like a blend of like two. It's like DJ Snake and it's a DJ Snake song mixed with like Club Action or whatever. So it's a blend of the two. I've never seen DJ Snake live.
I've heard good things about him, though.
Yeah, he's good. He's all right. He's all right. You know, run of the mill DJ.
You want to know what my pump up song is?
What is that?
You're going to think, you already think weird things about me, but I'm.
Nah, I don't think
you're. No, but about, trust me. After this.
Yeah, Amy Winehouse.
Close your eyes real quick so I can load it without you hearing it.
Yeah, go ahead. Close my eyes.
Ray J, bro.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I get it. He hit it first.
Hey, dude.
Damn.
Dude, how pissed off must he be that he's not as famous as her and he's more talented
than Kim?
Oh, for what he does, he's 100 times more talented than her.
He is. He's a very talented guy. Yeah, he's, you know, he has a voice. He knows how to act. He knows how to do it. He comes from a family from of entertainers. So his sister's a singer.
I love how everybody just kind of says, "Oh, Ray J, like this is a legit voice." If he had one wish, he'd be more famous. Get what I did there?
Yeah. I mean, he's doing his thing, though. He's actually... He's doing, like, investments and stuff like that. He's a millionaire.
You know, he gets the best sex every night. It's the same thing with Pete Davidson. Girls are now hooking up with Pete because they want to see why Ariana Grande was with Pete.
Yeah.
Now, Ray J probably gets the same thing from any girl because they go, what did he give Kim in the bedroom? I want to have it.
You know what's kind of crazy? I remember when I was working at Power 95.3 and Ray J was doing Guy Orange, or he was doing something. He had a hotel at the Grand Bohemian, which is in downtown Orlando. And they had to almost block off a whole section because there was like literally 200 women outside of that hotel trying to see him. Trying to get in the hotel room with him. Trying to get in the hotel just to see him.
You know what's funny?
Craziest thing I've ever seen in my life.
You know, girls often want to hook up with a guy because they want to see what it's like to have sex with that guy because they've heard things about him.
Yeah.
Guys are the difference.
Yeah.
Here's how guys are different. I want to hook up with a girl just to hook up with her. I never want to be like, oh, I want to hook up with her because my buddy hooked up with her and I want to see what she's like.
Yeah.
Like, guys are a little different where maybe it's just me.
Yeah.
But I don't like thinking about
you know,
been in there too.
Yeah, yeah. You don't want sloppy seconds. You don't want to like go in there and like thinking about your buddy that went in there too.
And I feel like girls, they don't see it as sloppy seconds. They see it as, what did this other female experience?
Really? You think so?
It's kind of sloppy seconds. Because why do you think Kate Beckinsale was seen snuggling with Pete Davidson at a party? She wouldn't have looked at Pete Davidson 2 years ago, but now Kate Beckinsale wants Pete Davidson in bed because she's like, what did he give Ariana Grande or Larry David's daughter? Think about it.
I never thought about it that way, huh?
Had one wish, bro. You know he's over Ariana now.
Who, Pete Davidson?
He's getting to probably bang Kate Beckinsale. That's an upgrade and some.
I don't know, man. I've been looking at Ariana Grande pictures lately, and I like her. I don't know why. She's growing on me. I don't even like girls that young, but
I don't think she's a freak though. I think she's just typical missionary doggy. I think it's very bland. But I feel like a girl like Kate Beckinsale that's a little bit older.
Yeah.
I feel like she's like the cougar to Pete Davidson.
I feel like Ariana Grande has that light switch though, or has that switch. If you hit her in the right spot, that freak comes out. You know what I mean? Everybody has that switch. It's just you got to hit it right.
Isn't it the best when you realize after a few times that you've figured out the switch for the girl?
Yeah.
Because nothing's weirder than when you're first having sex with the girl for the first time.
Yeah.
And you don't know what to do to make her happy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're just kind of going through the motions.
You're just winging it. You're just figuring it out. I'm like, hey, let me touch her right here. Let me see how this feels. And does she like it? Yeah, you like that? Yeah. No, it's always weird. It's always awkward the first time you're kind of getting with a chick.
Yeah, sex is a weird thing if you really think about it.
Yeah.
Like, do you ever... Okay, this is going to sound so weird.
Uh-huh. No, go ahead, man.
When you're done watching porn...
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever watch it for like 20 seconds and then feel gross about yourself?
Yeah, I feel like less of myself. Yeah, I'm like, what did I do? I go in the shower and I'm like looking at myself. I'm like, you're a sick individual. Yeah, I do.
The weirdest is when you watch it on your nice TV. So
you watch it on your nice TV, really?
So the problem is, and you got to grab the remote and you got to connect the remote to the TV and you're just hearing the pounding. You're hearing the girl moaning and you're like, they're having sex and I'm laying on my bed.
Yeah.
Like, there's kind of a weird vibe when you're done.
Yeah. My thing is, like, I don't want my porn to be loud enough for, like, the old lady next door doesn't hear it. You know what I mean? Like, I kind of get embarrassed. Like, after it happens and, like, if, like, the old lady hears it next door, I'm like, I'm just hoping that she didn't hear it, you know, and I'm walking out of the apartment.
You seem like the guy, though, where the porn isn't what bothers them. I feel like there's some girls that are probably loud for her. And she's probably heard you have sex.
Really? I don't know.
You're just in denial because she's the nice old lady to you and you don't want to think about her hearing a girl moaning. Because definitely have. Because you know there's some girls that try to be quiet, but they're not thinking.
Yeah.
And I bet she's like, oh, that was me in the 80s.
That was me back in Woodstock.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
I love how the older generations try to act like they're all classy. It's like, you had sex in mud. Shut up.
Yeah, yeah, right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You're not that classy. Get out of here.
Man, what's our generation going to be like in 30 years?
We're going to be tatted up and freaky.
It's going to be like a bunch of like little Xan people, like Lil Xan.
Yeah, you think
or all those rappers. They're not going to look good in 30 years.
You don't think so?
They're going to look horrible with their face tattoos. Even Post Malone, who I like. That's not going to age well.
That is one ugly ass dude. I'm sorry. His music's all right, but I feel like he's hideous.
I just don't get him. The only song I like by him is the one that nobody knows about, which is White Iverson. I mean, this is the only one I ever liked.
Ooh, that's my jam. That was the only one that I liked from him, too. That was like his first single.
And that was what you would hear on hip-hop radio. Once he got top 40, that was when it changed for me. Mm-hmm. I liked him when nobody knew about him, but then he changed. This is good post. I'm swaggin', when I saw what he looked like after hearing him, not what I expected.
Yeah, not what you expected. Yeah,
I thought he would look like a guy that'd be in a band Migos. And then when I saw it's this weird looking white dude, I was like, what? Same with Action Bronson. Yeah. I thought Action Bronson would look like Rick Ross.
Oh, really?
When I saw what Action Bronson looked like, I was like, no.
He's a fat dude with a beard. You know?
I mean, listen to this. Started rocking the sleeve, I can't buy with no jaws. What type of vibe does this song do for you? Like a house party, a club, chilling with a girl?
I think if I'm driving with my windows down and, you know, really nice weather, this would be something I put on.
You know what is my driving music?
What is
going
that?
Across the bridge, you got the windows down, you're thinking about how you're from Chicago and you don't get to experience this weather in Chicago. Every time. This song never gets old. Ever gets old for me.
Was the classic, Daft Punk? Bro. Daft Punk?
One more time, bro. The other song that was the most listened to song of 2018 for me on Spotify.
Yeah.
I was playing it for you before.
Mm-hmm.
This is when you know all my music is old.
Mm-hmm.
Is when it's One More Time.
Mm-hmm.
And then Rick Ross from 11 years ago. This is a beautiful music. This is really good.
You like you some Rick Ross?
Dude, I love me some Rick Ross.
You like Rick Ross the boss.
I mean, look how many Rick Ross songs I have saved on my Spotify. Look at this. I like Rick Ross, bro.
Yeah, you dig some. Yeah, you dig some Rick Ross.
Told you. Look at this. The best one is Bag of Money. My chick bad looking like a bag of money.
Remember this? Wait, is this the one with French Montana? Money over
everything, everything. It's with T-Pain.
Yeah.
Like 2011. Yeah, you looking like money. It makes no sense. My chick bad looking like a bag of money. My chick bad looking like a bag of money. This is the best one. This is the most underrated one. Devil is Alive. Masterminds. Like 2014, 2013.
Uh-huh. You know whenever we link up, my nigga. Oh yeah, I mean,
it's slow. Like you can't really chill to it.
Yeah, this one with Jay-Z in it. Yeah, I'm. Nigga, let's get this
money, nigga. Dude, SDK seems pretty impressed with the rap, I know.
Yeah? No, I mean, it is impressive that you know a lot of rap, you know?
Well, because that's what I listen to in Chicago, WGCI.
107.5.
JR in the morning.
No. I don't know if I could do GCI.
Why?
I don't know, man. It's too urban for me. I don't know. I like a balance.
I feel like you'd be good on, like, a B96.
B96?
I don't know what you would vibe. Maybe V1027.
What is like, that one?
Old Marvin Gaye and R&B. They'll go from playing Marvin Gaye to Prince to playing like, I don't know. You're putting me on the spot. Like a Trey Songz song.
Oh, okay. So it'd be kind of like a smooth R&B station.
Yeah.
So it'd be like the Quiet Storm all day.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's this JR. No, you could go by Baltazar.
Yeah, I could.
Hey,
yeah.
Baby. Like, do the Keith Sweat show that airs at night on 95.7 in Tampa.
Yeah.
But, like, do it as JR.
My style,
this is Baltazar.
Oh, man.
I think I just found a new radio show for you.
What is that?
Just doing Baltazar where you talk with a low voice. This is Baltazar. Up next is Brandy. I want to be down.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I'd be too raunchy. You know what I mean?
But that's a good thing. Yeah. You need to have that edge.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I could do that. I don't know if I want to do that.
I think you can make money in that, bro. Like, talking up this song while talking to a girl on the phone.
Go ahead.
Imagine that. I could see you doing that.
Yeah.
You're not giving yourself enough credit. With that voice, just say you're Baltazar and you're good, bro. Talk up some good songs by Ray J, Genuine.
Ooh, Genuine, yeah. I'll probably pull up some Genuine, yeah. I like Maxwell. Maxwell's a pretty decent artist, yeah. Erykah Badu, yeah.
Dude, she's great. I have her on my playlist, too. Listen to this. I told you I got this. Honey. Remember this? It's like 2008. The longest intro of Jesus Christ. A minute. I know she's a freak.
Is she?
She seems like she'd be a freak.
Yeah, she would be. Good for her, though. Good for her and her baby daddy.
Yeah. She's like the, who is that player for the Jets with all the kids?
Antonio,
Cromartie.
Antonio
she's
Cromartie?
Like the Cromartie of R&B.
You think so? Yeah, I know she has a kid with Andre, Jay Electronica, and somebody else.
That's a Cromartie life, but he has like 11 kids. That's the difference.
Yeah, it's two different things, yeah.
Well, bro, I think we should do this more often. I like
I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you having me, man.
I feel like this could grow into something. I'm digging the vibe. Playing my playlist and talking about the news. I could have you read the news, too.
Okay, yeah, I appreciate that, yeah.
And have this as the beat to open it up to. JR with the news.
Yeah, we could do better. But I got you. I see where you're going, yeah. I see where you're going, man. No worries.
You don't like Lenny Kravitz?
Hey, he's all right. You know, you could do better.
How do you like this?
I'd be the opposite. I'd be like, American woman, come to me. I'd be the opposite, dude. So I don't like that message that he's portraying.
He is sort of saying, get away from me.
Yeah, get away. Yeah, I don't want them to get away from me. You could come.
That's when you know you've had too much sex in your life.
Yeah,
is
right.
When you're like, American woman who's hot, get away from me.
White woman, get away from me, girl.
This could be your song. Same old hoes. Same
hoes. Yeah.
Different area codes, bro.
Yeah, I don't like calling women hoes.
Yeah, you're a classy gentleman.
Yeah, I respect women.
You do respect women. Nelly's good. I saw him live like 6 years ago. He's good.
You like Nelly?
I love Nelly, bro.
I know he's a good freestyler.
He had those Me Too things come up about him.
Oh, that did he really? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They got him too.
Who hasn't, though? Seems like everybody's had allegations.
Yeah, I might be Me Too soon, too. I don't know. Who knows?
Why?
No, I'm just saying, in general, yeah, I don't know. I guarantee you, like, some chick in high school was like, touch my booty.
Well, I don't send nudes anymore. Snap. I never should have anyway, but
yeah,
if I send it, it's for, like, a sec, and she's like, can I receive it? I'm like,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, you could just deny it. Be like, that's not me.
It'd be pretty easy to tell if it's me.
Oh, really? Yeah.
I'm 6'9", I have a certain body shape.
Ah, okay.
You wouldn't, like, I feel like, if there was a nude of you going around, you could go, is that JR? You would know it's me in a second.
Yeah, I'll just deny it until I die.
Well, bro, let's do this more often.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Yeah, I appreciate you having me.
Anytime, bro. Where can people find your work?
Let me see. On Instagram, JR Bernard. On Twitter, you could find me at BalthazarJR_. And yeah, you can find me on the Soul Brother Kevin Show from 6 to 9 on 102.5 The Bone.